if I put that rap in, because it's like first of all, like, you know, like, growing up in St. Louis, in the neighborhood that I grew up in, like, Hilltop area, there was, like, an abandoned school right down the neighborhood, which is crazy because it used to be a thriving school in the area, and it was, like, a good school to go to, and then, I guess, you know, money kept it from staying open and stuff, so me and my friends, and one of my best friends, Darren, we used to break into the school and, you know, just be up to a bunch of shit that we shouldn't have been. And I remember one time, like, we tripped an alarm inside of this abandoned school, and we all, like, ran. And the cops were so pissed at us, especially because, you know, we were mixed kids, you know. Like, I was mixed race, and, you know, the neighborhood we were in was very diverse. And so cops were really tough on kids growing up. And I remember, you know, we got in trouble from the cops. And I remember being, like, maybe 12 years old, and I'll never forget the way the cops treated us. I mean, we were just kids jumping a fence and messing around in the school, and the school had been shut down because it didn't have enough money to stay open, and our neighborhood kind of went to shit, and we were just having fun and bullshitting, and this cop made us scared. Like, I remember he threatened, like, he's like, "Oh, we'll lock you away," you know, like, and so, you know, Hilltop wasn't safe from the cops. You know, passing blunts in the lot of the AMC 12, like, me and my friends being stupid and, like, smoking, you know, weed outside of the movie theater, the AMC 12 in our neighborhood down the street, and, like, sneaking in, like, you know, like, I gotta admit, like, you know, growing up in a place like St. Louis and not having money, it's like, you have to find other ways to have fun, and, like, unfortunately, sometimes you can be involved in the wrong things, like, and I wouldn't condone, you know, kids rolling around, smoking, doing this and that, but in St. Louis, it was just a different mentality. It was just like, you know, it's this weird town because there's a ton of money in it. Like, there's, like, great neighborhoods. Like, the school that I graduated from and then went to NYU and got the scholarship to NYU from, it's such an amazing neighborhood, man. There are, like, you know, like, beautiful forests and, you know, like, just wealthy people, doctors, dentists, lawyers, all this stuff. And then you have, right on the other side of town, you have the poorest neighborhoods ever. You have the worst violence ever. You have this divide, the opportunity gap. It's, like, huge and prevalent. So I feel like taking on a record like this and writing about my life and talking about money and talking about, you know, a little bit about my struggle and shit, I think, like, maybe there will be something that I spotlight on growing up from my perspective in the Midwest, because I know a lot of kids grow up in different Midwestern towns, and St. Louis just happens to be one of those towns. So yeah, I'm excited. I want to do, like, some sort of, like, weird, like, so, you know, I have, like, so last time I checked, I still got the bow. What's it really mean? I'm still myself, my soul is worth anything. Then I want to switch into, like, this weird 8-bit, like, sci-fi, like, breathing, like, you know what I mean? Like,
that's not some Stranger Things. That's what that was.
Stranger Things, exactly.
That was Stranger Things, though, right?
Dude, I found these vintage pads, so, like, I want it to be, like, okay, hold on, let's find it. Alright, then I can go. Maybe I'll keep the low one,
like. Dude, that's tight.
Yeah, you know, I want some 8-bit, like.
Yeah, that's cool.
Stranger Things. He caught me. I love that shit. So it's like. And probably, you know what? I don't want the loop to come in right away, so I'll mute the loop. So it's just more like this. Overthinking about it too much. Overpaying for the gold rush. Then we can go back to the piano. So That will be layer number one, and I'll put a little like additional layer on the left and the right. So okay, that would be better if I do the octave like that. What's that? I love building and shit, man. It's so much fun. So it's like, who would go into a weird, like, you know, shit like that? And then maybe I need like a harmony, like, what's up, baby? Starting this crazy track right now called Manifest about money. Yeah. What'd you buy?
Christmas came early for Rogue Burnett.
I wonder why I spent my days in the hate. Running a lot of them denying, I was trying to find some peace in my life and try to take my own life. Alright. Shall be dope, my friend. And the rest, you're gonna have to wait.
There we go, right there. Perfect. Say hi again.
Making a long cameo in the video.
There we go. Yeah, that's tight.
I'm so excited. So, playing a little bit of Manifest stripped, just, you know, created some of the final touches on it and put it together. So, now some Saturdays waste away. I wonder why I spent my days in a haze. Caught in a lie, there's no denying I was trying to find some peace of mind. I even felt like taking my own life one time. No exaggeration, damn, my world is fading. I was suffocating, only 18, but with enough hate. There was something in my heart that couldn't keep waiting no more. I nearly shut my own doors before they really opened. My mama's back home, almost done hoping. Scared I'm gonna come back with this mind broken. But listen clearly, cause I'm not joking. This is a token of my love to you. This is what I've been through. But it ain't about what we've been through. Realize we had the crackling candle next to the little.
No, it sounds cool because it's
it's gonna be great.
It's gonna sound cool with it, yeah.
And now, you're finishing campfire sessions with Branda Burnett. Yay!
Campfire being candlelit.
I know. It's okay. One can dream.
So just.